In other news, latest here that's come in from SEBI. The SEBI Chief Ajay Tyagi has raised the issue of autonomy of the markets regulator, and this regarding the budget proposal, which had stated that SEBI transfer 25% of its surplus to the government. SEBI maintains that this move would hit the regulator's financial autonomy. SEBI Chief, in fact, has directly written to the Finance Ministry and the Prime Minister's office here, seeking a reconsideration of this proposal. Let's get in further details. Rahul Kumar getting us those inputs here. Rahul Kumar, without doubt, the SEBI making it very clear in the SEBI chief having written this letter here that there can be no insistence on part of the government.
Well, in fact, once again, the question of autonomy has arisen. And this time, the question of autonomy has arisen by the capital market regulator, SEBI. SEBI has written a letter to Finance Minister and Government of India, that is PMO, to once again consider the proposal to deposit surplus cash, 25% of surplus cash in Consolidated Fund of India. Well, let me tell you, not only SEBI chairman, SEBI's employees union and brokers have also written a letter to Finance Minister and PMO. Well, one by one, we will go in the content of what they have written. SEBI chairman has written that this proposed move would affect the functioning of SEBI as well as securities market, and highlighted the rationale for regulator keeping this reserve fund and importance on protecting interest of the investor. SEBI employees union have made it very clear, and they have written that transfer of surplus fund of general fund to Consolidated Fund of India, and after that, in case of any requirement is made by SEBI, they will have to take permission from Finance Minister of India. Now, this say this is a threat to the autonomy of SEBI. Mm-hmm. And one more thing they have highlighted, this is against the spirit of SEBI Act 1992. Now, brokers are also not very happy with this step of Finance Minister, and they have written that government, this proposal could lead to government interference in day-to-day happening of SEBI functioning. Fund of CFI will not be used for development of capital market. Now, brokers have made it clear that the entire fund which is being generated by capital market should be used for development of capital market only. Now, as far as total fund in SEBI is required, SEBI has around 2300 crore right now, and in the first go, if the proposal is not being rejected, then it will have to deposit 75% of that 2300 crore in the first go, and after that it will have to deposit 25% of money annually, and it should not exceed the total expenditure of 2 years. But as far as entire unions are concerned, as far as SEBI chairman is concerned, as far as brokers are concerned, brokers, they are not very happy with this step of Government of India, and they want government to reconsider this decision.
That's right, Rahul. This also being an indication that there were no consultations beforehand, before this announcement was made in the budget. SEBI was unprepared for what was mentioned in the budget.
Indeed, we have talked with brokers as well. We are in talk with SEBI Employees Union as well. And they are clearly saying that there were no consultation before, and this is completely a threat to their autonomy. Because SEBI has a very different revenue model as far as other regulators are concerned. SEBI does not require much money from Government of India. It has its own subscription model and other models to meet its day-to-day requirement. And as far as transferring of that surplus cash is concerned, it can pose a threat to their autonomy in coming days, and brokers are not very happy with this.
Yes, Rahul, stay on with us. We're getting in more voices here as well. Mr. J.N. Gupta, who's the founder and MD, Stakeholders Empowerment Services and former ED of the SEBI. Mr. Gupta, thank you for being with us. In your view, in your understanding of the situation, this is a very strongly worded letter that has been written in by the SEBI chief regarding autonomy.
Objective of setting up a regulatory agency is to ensure that they operate independent of the government of the day. And for any independence, economic and financial independence is very, very important. It is the root, it is the core of independence. And if economic or financial independence is not there, you are hitting the basic root. Today, no company can be said to be 100% independent of another country if it is dependent upon the financial thing. An individual is not independent unless until it has a financial independence. And we all talk about financial independence. So, the moment there is some sort of a connection between the government and the regulatory agency about the finances, then its independence is impacted. And the question that I am raising is, why government wants it when audit of SEBI is done by CAG? Does it not have a confidence in a CAG? And the second issue that we are saying, that that all of the regulatory agencies, is RBI dependent on government of India? No. So the issue is that regulatory agency must be having a financial freedom where they are created by the law. And if you give a lot of power to them on paper, but they do not have financial freedom, then they are like a paper tiger with a paper legislation, but no independence.
That's right. We appreciate you speaking with us. Also, having pointed out there, does this also raise questions as far as the work of CAG is done on why should the government be seeking this transfer? Thank you.